Good morning, members of Brackenness Church. It is good to be sharing devotions with you this Friday morning. For those that do not know me, my name is Reverend Terry Hall. Today I will be referring to various scripture passages, but I will start at the reading of a portion of Luke 24. This records the story of the disciples on the road to Emmaus, and it speaks about how Jesus walked with them on their journey. I'll read from verse 28. As they approached the village to where they were going, Jesus continued as if he was going to go further, but they urged him strongly, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, the day is almost over." So he went on to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it to them, and began to give it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. He disappeared from their sight. They asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?" They got up and returned at once to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 and those with them assembled together and saying, "It is true, the Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then the two told what had happened on the way and how Jesus was recognized by them when he broke the bread. Since the beginning of Lent, I have been using a devotional book based on the hymn, "Be Thou My Vision, O Lord of My Heart." I have been reflecting upon what the meaning of God's vision is for both now and for the future. I have come to understand that God's vision is for his kingdom to come about in all its fullness. We read in Revelation 21, verses 1 to 5. "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, and I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people.'" If we look at the world today, we obviously long for that new heaven and the new earth to be here, because what we see and experience is not God's kingdom in its fullness. To be able to understand what is happening today, we can look at the good news of Jesus, which is the kingdom of God is now. It has arrived, it is arriving, it will arrive in all its fullness. The question that I've been reflecting on is, how can I see God's kingdom now? Where is it working? I've come to understand that my ability to see God's kingdom now depends on my ability to see, i.e. my sight. Many of us have the ability to see with our eyes. Sometimes we only see what we want to see. Other times we see things on a surface level. We see a tree, we see people, we see buildings. And because we are so used to seeing them, we do not stop to take a second glance. I think that if we are going to see God active in our lives at this time, maybe we'll need to develop our seeing ability. To this end, I find focusing on two lines from the song, "Have You Seen Jesus My Lord," helpful. The lines are as follows. "Have you seen Jesus my Lord? He is in plain view. Open your eyes and you'll see him." You see, Jesus is in plain view, and often we don't see him. In scripture, there are references to people's eyes being opened. In John 9, verse 25, we read, "One thing I do know, once I was blind, now I see." In Matthew 9, verse 29, we read, "Then he touched their eyes, and their eyes were opened." In Luke 24, verse 31, disciples on the road to Emmaus, their eyes were opened as Jesus broke bread with them and they recognized him. Even though Jesus was walking and talking with them, and the fact that they must have seen him, they didn't recognize him. Once they recognized Jesus, they ran back to the other disciples and told them they had seen Jesus. The disciple told them that they had also seen Jesus. They realized that Jesus was alive, but different from what he was before his resurrection. I believe that we want to see Jesus alive and acting in our lives today, in the lives of people around us, and in the world. We must start with a desire to see, and then live expecting to see Jesus alive and active. We then need to practice seeing at a greater depth than merely seeing on a surface level. I remember those pictures which could only reveal the image within them when one concentrated and peered into them. I always had difficulty seeing that image. I also remember as a child on trips from Grahamstown to Port Alfred, my mother pointing out a tree that she saw as a rabbit leaping over a hill. Everyone said that they saw the rabbit except me. Later on, I realized that what they were talking about was a forest of trees, where I was looking for one single tree. I was not seeing what they were seeing because I was looking for something different. I had formed a different vision to their vision of what they were looking at. So where do we want to see Jesus active today? I believe that our expectations of where we would like to see Jesus would differ according to the context in which we find ourselves. Some of us would like to see Jesus performing a miracle and eradicating COVID-19. Others would like to see Jesus as he walks with people who are suffering during this time, seeing his presence comforting and encouraging them, just being with them in their suffering and suffering with them. Maybe we would like to see Jesus in the eyes of the kind of people who alleviate the suffering of others, such as by nursing the sick and providing food parcels to the hungry, and also just by being with people, bringing a kind word and let them know that they're not just statistics, but that each of them is a person in God's eyes. I know this sometimes is often very difficult because we cannot see God working in people's lives. Mother Teresa, who worked with the destitute in Calcutta, said that she meets God as he disguises himself as a person in need. People need also saw Jesus in Mother Teresa. Where we can most effective in allowing people to see Jesus in us, I think a plus place where this can happen is in our home environment. When we are on top of each other all day long, it's very easy to become irritated. In some reading that I've been doing, I've come across a narrative idea that in our everyday interactions with those we love, we are responsible for the ways our actions and words shape the stories of their lives. We thus should be ever mindful of the times that our actions, intentional or not, encourage others to enter into negative or impoverishing stories of themselves. In other words, we are responsible for helping others to see Jesus in our actions, responses, and the way we talk and treat people we come into contact with. Will we make mistakes? Yes, we will. What we can do, however, is to start the day asking God to help us to see with his eyes and to respond in ways in which people can see Jesus in us. At the end of the day, we can ask God to show us where he was with us during the day and to show us how and where we were able to make his presence known. And so, brothers and sisters, as we go into the world today, let us be mindful of God's presence with us and where he is present with other people. And as we finish, I would like to share a prayer with you, which we can carry into the day. Open my eyes that I may see your presence that is all about me. Open my ears that I may hear your voice that is quiet yet ever near. Open my heart that I may feel your love, O God, close and real. Open each sense and make me aware of your power and peace always there. God be with you as you move into your day. Amen.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me, say that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night, waking or sleeping, thy presence my light. Be thou my wisdom and thou my true keep.